around 50 members of the royal family, including Prince Charles, 73, and his wife Camilla, Duchess of Cornwall, 74, are expected to gather at Windsor Castle next Tuesday for the Queen's Christmas lunch. As the Duke and Duchess of Sussex are residing in California with their two young children Archie and Lilibet, and the implementation of travel restrictions due to the spread of the COVID Omicron variant, it is unlikely that they will travel across the pond to attend. Last year, the Queen's lunch with the firm didn't go ahead because of the pandemic, but moves to cancel the event for the second year are being resisted. The extended family will enjoy wine, crackers and a feast inside the castle next week, ahead of traditional festivities that will be hosted over Christmas at Sandringham, Norfolk, by the Queen. Another news, Prince William dreamed of moving to America and fleeing royal life before Harry and Meghan made the leap, an old report has suggested. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle retired from royal life in March 2022 and now live in California. During William's time as a student at the University of St. Andrews, the royal family had reportedly put a list of rules in place to make sure the privacy of the firm was protected. According to a report from the Scotsman in 2003, this contributed to William's dream of fleeing to the States once he graduated. Louise Pearson, a reporter for the publication, wrote at the time, "Having enjoyed a degree of privacy as a student at St. Andrews, perhaps it's not such a surprise that William has announced his intention to spend a few years living in the U.S. after he finishes his degree. Work in a gallery or auction house, and the possibility of a postgraduate degree, have apparently been discussed." The Duke of Cambridge started at the Scottish University in 2001 after taking a gap year, where he worked on a farm, took part in army training exercises in Belize and spent 10 weeks teaching children in southern Chile. William began a degree in art history but later switched to geography. A courtier told the Scotsman in 2003, "William is determined to maintain a degree of anonymity and feels America offers him the best chance of that." Ms. Pearson added it would have been an unprecedented move. She continued, "But William seems determined to forge his own path. He rarely undertakes royal duties and signs his checks," William wails. Harry and Meghan, who continue to reside in Montecito, California, have still not provided any indication on where they will be spending the festive holiday this year. The couple had no choice but to stay in the U.S. last year due to coronavirus restrictions. It is understood Her Majesty will be hosting the family round for their traditional festive celebrations at Sandringham, but this will depend on the Omicron variant situation. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex are still yet to return to the UK as a couple since they retired from royal life last year. Harry has returned on his own for a couple of occasions, however, including his grandfather's Prince Philip's funeral and the unveiling of his mother Princess Diana's statue. Neil Sean, a royal expert, said that the couple's gift exchanging with the rest of the royal family will be very formal this year. He added, "But let's just say whatever they do send each other over, it will be at a distance." While Harry revealed the full extent of the brothers' rift on a tour of South Africa in 2019. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex gave a revealing interview during the trip to ITV's Tom Bradby. Harry said of William, "We are certainly on different paths at the moment, but I will always be there for him and I know he will always be there for me. We don't see each other as much as we used to because we are so busy, but I love him dearly. The majority of stuff is created out of nothing, but as brothers, you know, you have good days, you have bad days.